Sims! Congrats on claiming first! Like this chat.
Hey!
the same boy I used to be. Do you want to dance?
Clock strikes upon the hour, and the sun begins to fade.
Clap those cheeks, besties!
Still enough time to figure out how to chase my blues away. I've done all right up till now. It's the light of day that shows me how. And when the night falls, my lonely heart falls.
Conversation. Welcome to Monday. Welcome to Monday. Monday fun day. Today, I think we're going to start with some Speedstorm because I haven't played it in a couple of days. I think last time I played it on stream was the last time I played it, which was Friday, wasn't it? Casper, welcome in. So yeah, we're going to start with some Speedstorm, but we're not going to do Speedstorm all night, I don't think. Probably toward the end of the night. I'll swap to like Jedi Survivor because I also haven't played that since I played it on stream. And I've been watching Daddy Aquathor play that game, and I'm like, oh, I want to get these new powers. So we're going to do that. Swifty, how you doing? How you doing, Swifty? It's good to see you. I hope everyone had a wonderful weekend. If you celebrate Mother's Day, I hope you had a wonderful time. I did call mine. I was actually thinking about doing the arm on my chair is like starting to break. So I'm trying to push it back in its thing. I thought about doing a bonus stream yesterday just because I was a little bit bored, and then you all yelled at me in Discord and said, take the day off. So I took the day off. But I was going to do a cute little thing. I was going to call my mom on speakerphone, while live on stream, and let you all ask her questions about me. But hope all you bottoms and fellow verses are having a lovely evening celebrating our favorite top. Please, Wes, please stop, but don't. I hooked up with a hot guy Friday night, spent most of Saturday at a bestie's pool, but then that hot couple texted, so I hooked up with them. Went back out Saturday night and was a potato yesterday after Mom's Day stuff. Swifty had a good weekend. Swifty's weekend was better than mine. Are you still able to walk, Swifty? Prism Render, how you doing? How you doing? I had a bad weekend, and I'm so sorry, Twisted. That's a bummer. That's a bummer. I hate to hear it, but tomorrow's a new day, and hopefully we can manifest. Some crazy noises going on outside that I can hear. I don't think you guys can because of the filters in OBS, but I'm hearing everything that comes through this mic. I hope we can manifest some more positive things for your day tomorrow, Twisted. Keep that bus elevated. Yeah, you don't want anything leaking out. I survived the weekend looking for volunteers to hold me all weekend next year so that I don't have to deal with it alone again. That's fair. Your PS5 is here in Colorado, so hopefully you'll get it tomorrow. I'm so excited for you, Casper. I took my mom out to DQ after I crashed in my coins. I have not been to a DQ in forever. I'm trying to think where the closest one is to here. I think it might be up in Glendale. One volunteer would be enough. I'm not greedy. That's fair. That's fair. Doing well. Oh! Did you want to come say hi? Did you want to say hi? I guess. Doing well. I had a normal weekend. Saw my mom and got lunch. Made plans with my partner's mom and mine to get brunch next Sunday. Oh, that's fun.
For the pimple, for the prayer, for good luck.
Thank you, MacDoodle, MacMoo, for the 300 biddies. Thank you. For the pimple, for the prayer, for good luck. Thank you, MacDoodle. I've been trying to dry it out with rubbing alcohol. So, I always look after the welfare of the buses. We need the buses. There would be no tops without buses. I would hang out with you, Mama Sims. Wait, what is this emote, Prism? What's this emote? Look at that. That's so cute. Oh my goodness. That is a cute emote. MacDoodle, thank you for the 300 biddies. Thank you so much. Yeah, we do have a special guest on stream tonight. I tried to get it off my face before today, but it was not in the cards. I don't like popping them because then they can scar, so I've been trying to dry it out with rubbing alcohol. My inner thighs are so sore today. I need some more information there, Prism. I need more information. Your book has been keeping me company. I hope you're enjoying it, Twisted. Twisted started reading my book this past weekend. Mama Sims, I need more information. I think we would all like more information. obviously, of course, if you want to share. And I'm like, it's like starting to itch, but like, I don't want to like mess it up or get oil on it. So I'm just kind of like trying to like scratch the skin around it. I don't know about drying your skin out. As not a dermatologist, I think it's good to exfoliate and use retinol. I think I've got, I don't know, like my skin is so weird. I mean, I'm already on some medications for like other dermatological stuff. Like I have an autoimmune disorder that's dermatological based that I'm on meds for, but like I have an exfoliant. But like I feel like just my skin gets like tacky when I use it, and then I feel like within a day or two like I'm getting a bunch more pimples from it, so I don't use it that often. Today is going by slowly now because I want my PS5 now. One more sleep, Casper. One more sleep. One more sleep, and your PS5 will arrive. I brought it to therapy, and my therapist was intrigued by it. He told me to let him know how it is when it's done. Excellent. Excellent. How many of the stories have you finished? Just the first one. I know last time I talked to you, you were almost done with the first story in it. I just went to the gym on Saturday for the first time in years, but it's weird, like, the soreness skipped it. Oh, yeah. Yeah, the worst is, like, not the direct day after, but the day after that, because your body is like, oh! Skin is just irritating to deal. Yes. Exactly. 41 years old and still get pimples. Those exfoliating strips that pull the sebum plugs out of all the blocked pores are supposed to be good with steam to open the pores before. Yes. In fact, I need to get more of those. I would like to do some of those. But like the exfoliant I have, it's like, it's a really nice exfoliant. It was like one of the high-end ones. It was, shit. What's the brand name? Somebody's Choice? Not Sophie's Choice. No. Elizabeth, no. I don't know. Skincare people, help me out here. I usually only go to the gym if it's raining or I want a short workout. If it's nice outside, I like to hike or run track. I got two chapters to go for bed. Okay. Ron Weasley's worst night. Yes. Paula's! Thank you, Prism. Yes, Paula's Choice. I knew it was one of those pretty bitches. Yep. Yep. It was one of them that was recommended by like a big famous dermatology doctor that I follow on Instagram and TikTok and all that shit. Hi, Isolation! Used to get body acne. I had a lot. Those days are gone. I don't have it anymore. That's nice. I do. Still. Always. Everyone's like, you only get pimples when you're a teenager. Lies. Lies. My day was just made by Tim streaming. Oh, okay. Nowhere else to go, besties. I love popping pimples. I just don't want to scar my face. I'd like the eczema on my hands to go away, but the blackheads I get around the edges of my scalp are from wearing a beanie 24/7. I accept them as the price of keeping my scalp warm. That's fair. That's fair. Yeah. So, I thought about just, like, putting a Band-Aid over it to, like, hide it, but screw it. We're gonna let it air out. We're gonna let it air out. I have acne right now. I'm almost 30. Yep. It doesn't ever stop. It doesn't ever stop. So, whoever tries to tell us it does is a liar. They're a liar. Y'all, I missed you. I missed you a lot. I did get a lot of sleep this weekend, though. I personally find imperfections adorable. Some people do. It's funny because, like, in other people, I find them adorable, but, like, in myself, I'm like, no, get it away. I always tend to scratch by accident, and then I get a scar. Yeah. Yep. As a non-medication pain relief goes, a beanie is amazing for migraines. Interesting. Interesting. You guys don't hear the sirens, do you? I hear them real loud. Thank God for filters. This mic picks up absolutely everything. So, if any of you are on the Twitter app, I replied to a public tweet from the Disney Speedstorm account. They were asking how many content creators are out there making Speedstorm content. And I immediately replied, Beast Man Productions, thank you so much for that follow. I immediately replied, yes, hi, I stream Speedstorm a lot. Because, you know, that's a good way to, you know, like, interact with devs of games you enjoy and whatnot. Twitter is really good for that. Welcome, bud. This is actually what I've been trying to get through to them. Yeah. If you see that tweet, you know, as Wes said in the Discord, make sure you like it and you retweet it and all that stuff. Hi, it's me. It's me. Hi, I'm the problem, it's me. Said Swifty. Our Swifty. Well, the other Swifty said it too, obviously. Beastman, welcome in. It's good to see you. Are you a Speedstorm player as well? You are never a problem, just a sweetheart. You know, the internet is wild because, like, I stare, like, at this chat of all these people, like, streaming specifically, and, like, I get close with a lot of the people in this chat, and I see you chat in Discord, but, like, I don't really know who any of you are. Like, I mean, Twisted could actually be a 16-year-old boy pretending to be, you know, an adult woman, you know, and so it's just, it's wild to think, like, I wonder, like, how many people I'm talking to are, like, actually who they present, because that's the fun of the internet, is that you can be whoever you want to be on the internet, you know, like, if you had a shitty past, the internet doesn't need to know about that stuff. You can just kind of present who or what you want to present to the world. So it's just wild to think that. I mean, obviously, there are some people that I've met IRL. And it's also interesting, too, and that's why, like, I don't know how to word this without it sounding like my AI programming says I'm real. Nice. But it's like, there's something about being a streamer that is, like, a little bit kind of like being a celebrity, like not the famous part of being a celebrity, but just like you get all of these people who, like, know you and watch you and want to interact with you. But, like, you're just up there like, I don't know who these people are. That's why, like, celebrities often, like, date and marry other celebrities, because, like, that is somebody that they do know and gets it. And that's why it's, like, so fun to, like, go out drinking with Kian and Wido and Isaac Ho, because, like, I don't know. It's wild. Like, I don't really know where I'm going with this. It's just kind of, like, it's interesting to, like, think about all of this stuff. You know, we've talked about parasocial relationships before on stream, and it's, like, you know, the fact that I like all of you so much, but it's like, who are you and who am I? You know, I guarantee that, like, my brain isn't capable of, like, acting like somebody totally different that well. So, like, what you see here is mostly me, but it is an exaggerated, more extroverted version of me. Like, I am pretty severe introvert once the camera turns off. But I don't know. It's just like, these are some of the things I was thinking about this past weekend. I was like, I just want to share them. Anyway, no, I have breasts and a vagina. I am real and honest. I am me. I went to the gyno today, so I am for sure a female. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Okay, we're good now. Hi, Pearl! I thought I wasn't gonna get it sick. Guess what happened? Did you get sick? I'm a Disney gay that's not an AI. I learned to be an expert liar when I was a child, as most abused kids do, but in adulthood, I find that far too exhausting. Yeah. Yeah. I have things I don't tell people because doxing yourself is not correct. Yeah. Hi, Barrist! How are you? Yeah, you probably relate to a lot of this conversation, Beastman. I need to repurpose one of my Twitter alts for this community because I don't want to mix that with my Sims Twitter. Oh, for sure. I have multiple Twitter accounts as well. I have the streaming one. I have my like personal one that I don't use too much anymore. And then I also have the Twitter that I on. My username kind of implies I'm a bear when I'm actually a lesbian. Well, I mean, you also have the pronoun extension for pronouns that says she, they. So I always assumed you were female presenting. I do want to visit all in LA. I think it would be exhausting to try and keep up being someone else. Yeah. I'm shy. I would love to hang out with more people, but it's always scary to meet IRL. I do well with social activities, but need a break sometimes. Yeah. Can confirm also being of the breasts and vagina sort, have pushed out 5 babies and spent a total of over 14 years breastfeeding. Doing okay? I missed you. How are you? I'm great. I'm great. I had a great weekend. I slept for 14 hours last night. I went to bed at 11 p.m. last night and then slept till 1 in the afternoon today. I need to know what got bleeped there. I would go out with people, but my epilepsy I have, so I don't drink alcohol that much. I don't drink too much either. I do, but I mean, not every stream has that front and center. Yeah, that's true. That's true. I love how streaming got me to actually step out of my cave and speak with random people openly, which is yes. Yeah. Yep, for sure. Streaming is wild. Brewski, welcome in. How you doing, Brewer? When it comes to Twitch, for me, it's about the community and how they can turn a bad day into a good one. I am probably biased, but I have the best community. I love you guys so much. I can't be in a room with more than 8 or 9 people. My panic disorder and anxiety. See, I'll tell you what, Pearl, like I am. I'm weird because like I don't like huge, loud crowds, but at the same time, I would rather go to a party than just like a one-on-one, because like when it's a one-on-one, I feel like so much more pressure to be the one carrying conversation. Whereas if I'm with a group, I can just kind of like sit back and laugh at the jokes and listen and just kind of be there, you know? Also, like, you know, with the autistic traits too, it can also be challenging hanging out with people that you feel like you have to mask around. So, I mean, obviously I do have a few friends who I just don't feel like I need to mask around and like I'm never stressed to hang out with them, certainly. Okay. After you told me about Dead Space, it's definitely copied by Callisto. Well, the devs of Callisto Protocol are the devs of the original Dead Space, Matthew. And after they came out with Callisto Protocol, it kind of became obvious that that's the only game they know how to make. Because Callisto Protocol is pretty much just Dead Space. When I'm out in public, I'm pretty nearly always blindfolded these days because of the photosensitivity. But wearing a blindfold means I don't want to wear a COVID mask because there's nothing left on my face. Yeah, fair. Yep. Hello, Zone. Just say in its own way, it's hot garbage. Well, I haven't played it myself, so I don't want to boldly suggest I know what it is, but I have seen a lot of people play it, and from what I've seen, it looks just like Dead Space. can't be around new people because I'm shy at first. Then once you get to know me, I don't shut up. I'm very shy around new people. Yep. For sure. I had diagnosed with panic disorder when I was 15. When the classes in high school were freaking huge, but I adjusted and got used to it. Now I'm an adult and hate going to parties. I can go to parties, but I have to mentally prepare for it. Like, I'm not good at last minute plans. Like, if somebody texts me and says, hey, we're headed to the bar, want to join us? I'm like, no. Like, I have to like have a plan in place. Like, okay, tomorrow I'm meeting friends at the bar, and then like I can mentally prepare for it and get myself in the right place. I'm usually pretty friendly, not super shy, but typically open up more and more you get to know me. Yeah. New people doesn't bother me. We'll say when I do visit you guys, M needs to be there too. Well, you'll have to talk to M about that. M lives 5 hours away from me. But I'm sure M would love to meet you. Okay. Oh, God, I want to show you. I want to show you guys something. I've been diagnosed with panic disorder for 20 years and was taking toxic meds for it, 15 of them. Now I'm off meds. Anxiety levels are lower than they were on the meds. Yeah. Yep. I have a hard time on short notice. Uh-huh. Yep. I played a new song during the Starting Soon screen. I'm always down to attempt to hang out with people from the community, but I never know how far anyone is, minus my talk as if. Yeah. Isolation and I are fairly close. I mean, not too close, but within an easy driving distance for sure. Excuses, sorry, I'm sick right now, maybe another time. There was a new song that we played at the end of the Starting Soon screen. And I've been obsessed with it. It's an old song, it came out in 2004, but I'm obsessed with it. And the music video is just... So I'm going to play it for you guys. I'm going to I'm going to have to speed it up by 25%. So we don't get DMCA'd. But this music video, I just need you guys to see it. I just need you to see it. And then we'll start Speedstorm. I'm not big on large gatherings unless I have prep time. Yeah. It's the trauma I don't bring up because it's a lot for people and I don't want them to feel bad for me and make them sad. Okay. Okay, so this is going to be sped up by 25%. So hopefully we don't get DMCA'd. But I don't know. I saw this yesterday and I was like, I need to share this. I need to share this. So here we go. We're going to share. Okay, window capture. Okay, here we go. Here we go, besties. Okay, let me turn off the music. Okay. This music video is just...